Hi, I'm Lake Speed Jr., Certified Lubrication Specialist from Driven Racing Oil, and today we're at the Speedway Motor Shop to answer a frequently asked question. Which viscosity grade should I run? Everybody knows about viscosity grades like 2050 and things like that, but what does viscosity actually mean? Viscosity is just a fancy word for resistance to flow. The important thing to keep in mind is that all oils get thinner as they get hotter. You may have heard that a 20W50, for example, is a 20 when it's cold and a 50 when it's hot. But if you think about it, that's actually wrong. That would mean the oil would get thicker as it got hotter. So it's not a 20 when it's cold and a 50 when it's hot. All oils get thinner as they get hotter. That number after the W is the viscosity of the oil, the resistance of the oil to flow at high temperature. The best way to think about viscosity is like pancake syrup. It's really thick when it's cold, but it thins out when it's hot. So as a result, an engine that has a really high oil temperature needs a higher viscosity grade oil. You think about, say, a pro stock engine that runs like a 0W5 oil, but the oil temperature is only about 100 degrees Fahrenheit versus, say, a 410 sprint car where the oil temperature could be 300 degrees Fahrenheit and they run a 2050 or a 1550. So keep in mind the oil temperature is always going to have an impact on what viscosity grade to run, but there's another variable to keep in mind, and that's your bearing clearances. The rule of thumb is the wider the bearing clearance, the thicker the oil has to be, which can mean a higher viscosity grade oil if the oil temperature is high, which is going back to our pro stock example. A really low temperature engine doesn't need as high a viscosity oil, but the oil viscosity still has to match the bearing clearance. The wider the bearing clearance, the thicker the oil has to be at operating temperature. The other thing to keep in mind is really tight bearing clearances also need thinner oil. Well, that kind of gives you an idea a little bit about viscosity grades, bearing clearances, oil temperature. But we're not done yet. There's still a few more variables. If you're running, say, race gas, all that goes with it. But let's say, for example, you've got 2,500 bearing clearance at 220 degrees oil temperature, and you can run a 10W30 for that setup. If you go from race gas to methanol, you have to go up one viscosity grade. When you run a richer air fuel mixture like methanol or E85, now you get more fuel dilution, thinning the oil out. You have to compensate for that by going up one viscosity grade. So now you're 2,500 bearing clearance at 220 degrees. Now you're running a 1040 versus a 1030. If you have a supercharged engine running on methanol, you just need grease fittings. In all seriousness, the same rules apply. You go up a viscosity grade every time you increase boost or increase fuel dilution. So in all reality, the supercharged engine running on methanol, you go up two viscosity grades, which is why 2,500 bearing clearance on a small block, you would run 10W30 normally, but if you're running a supercharged engine on methanol, you're running a 2050. In summary, viscosity is the most important characteristic of a lubricant. Viscosity changes with temperature, and you need to choose your viscosity grade based on your bearing clearances, your oil temperature, other factors such as what fuel you're running, if it's boosted or naturally aspirated. To make it easy for you, we've come up with a chart that actually shows which viscosity grade you should be using based on oil temperature and bearing clearances. And then you can adjust up based on what fuel you're using or if it's boosted or naturally aspirated. Whole idea, make it easy for you to choose the right viscosity for your engine and your application. Thanks for watching.